Hey y'all, and welcome back to my channel. So today we are finally reviewing all of the new Honest Beauty products. So they just launched a new tinted moisturizer, powder blushes, and brow pencils, and they kind of did it under the radar. Like, they haven't really been hyping it up on their social media. Actually, a couple of y'all reached out to me and let me know about it. Otherwise, I had no idea. So I've got all of those products today. I've got their tinted moisturizer. I have all of their powder blushes and then their two brow pencils. I'm going to give you an in-depth review of all these products. This is not a first impressions. I have been testing all of these products out and I have a lot of thoughts. So y'all know how in-depth I am and I always take notes. So I've got all my notes right here and I'm definitely going to give y'all my thoughts on these products and whether I think they are worth, you know, investing in and picking up. So before we get into the video, grab something to drink as always, and let's get into it. So in the spirit of trying out some new Honest Beauty stuff, I thought I would also use a bunch of Honest Beauty products that I already have and that I know that I love as well. So first, just to prep my lips, I don't really talk about this that often, but I really, really love this. This is their Magic Beauty Balm. It's just a multi-purpose balm. You can use it anywhere you want, but I like it on my lips. So I'm just gonna prep my lips with a little bit of this. All right, and then for primer, I talk about this all the time. This is their Everything Primer in the Glow version. They do have a mattifying one, but I like the glow one. It's not overly like shimmery or anything like that. I find that it's acts more like a moisturizer and it gives the skin a nice glow. So one of their new launches, probably the biggest launch I feel like, is their Luminous Finish Tinted Moisturizer with Broad Spectrum SPF 30. So per usual, I have all my notes right here. I'm going to read you just some of the information, some of the claims, and then I'll kind of get into what I actually think about this product. So this retails for $21.99. You get 1 ounce. This is about the same price, or I think it is the same price as their cream foundation. This only comes in 4 shades, and that is just, yeah, they definitely need to expand their shade range. I did reach out to my kind of contact with the brand and ask them if they were going to be expanding their shade range. I haven't heard back, but I'll definitely let y'all know. This has a mineral SPF of 30. The claims are this is a 6-in-1 multitasker. It primes, perfects, protects, blurs, brightens, and locks in moisture for 12 hours. It has blue light defense. This is a vegan formula. The first ingredient is water. It also contains cocoa caprylate, which I believe contains coconut oil, dimethicone, mica, glycerin. It does contain phenoxyethanol, and the two kind of star ingredients in this are a vitamin C. It's an oil-soluble form of vitamin C, and then it has this botanical blend for filled with a bunch of antioxidants. There's no fragrance in here, so that's a big plus. And then kind of going back to the cocoa caprylate, I've been wearing this quite a bit lately, and I haven't gotten any breakouts. It has not broken me out, so big thumbs up. But we're gonna go ahead and get into the application of this. So it does have a nice pump. I like that. I got the shade light, which is actually too dark for me. There is a shade lighter than this, which is fair. So I'm gonna blend it out with an Eco Tools sponge. This blends out great with a brush, a sponge, your fingertips. Today I just felt like using a sponge. I didn't really feel like getting my hands all dirty, but I've been applying it with my hands just because it's quicker. All right, so this is one solid layer of the tinted moisturizer. I would say this is about light coverage, but it is very buildable. You can definitely get medium coverage out of this. I was actually really shocked by the coverage. You can get quite a bit of coverage out of this. So in terms of the texture, the two foundations I would probably compare it to most are the Vapor Soft Focus Foundation and the Ilia True Skin Serum Foundation. So I pumped a little bit of each of those on the back of my hand so you could see the textures. So here is the Honest Beauty Tinted Moisturizer. This is the Ilia Foundation and this is the Vapor Foundation. So to me, Even though the Honest Beauty one is a little bit more runny, actually a lot more runny, I feel like the textures between these three are very, very similar. They're kind of like that oily, slightly serum-y type of texture. The Ilia and the Vapor are a lot thicker, but the feel of them, they feel very, very similar to those. It has a very similar finish to the Vapor foundation in terms of luminosity and that dewiness. It's not a shimmer or a glitter or anything like that. It's definitely just a very just luminous, dewy finish. Really, really pretty though. For oily skin, I don't know how great this would be, but for my skin, I actually quite enjoy it. And I really like the texture. It's like a gel, oil, serum all mixed together. So I actually quite enjoy it as well. But I'm gonna build it up a tiny bit just to show y'all how it builds. And I'm just applying a little bit to my hand. I'm gonna take my finger and just apply a little bit more to the areas where I want more coverage. And like I said, this shade is way too dark for me. So the shade light, that's very, very deceiving because I feel like I have a good amount of color to my skin, especially since I've been outside and working in the yard, and this is way too dark for me. All right, so this is what the foundation looks like up close on my phone. Again, very, very dewy finish. You can still see freckles and some redness and some spots, but overall, just a really, really pretty finish. Again, very, very dewy, but I think it looks really nice. There's no noticeable smell. It just kind of smells like makeup. This is not a long wearing product. I probably got a solid 3 to 4 hours out of this, and then it really started to break up on my chin and look really patchy. So in comparison to something like the Ilia Super Serum Skin Tint, that is a very, very long wearing kind of tinted moisturizer type of product. This is nowhere near as long wearing as that. So far, I actually quite enjoy it. My biggest issues with this are the shade range and just the wear time. But you know, typically for tinted moisturizer type of products, that's the norm. I haven't experienced any breakouts, and it does look really, really nice on the skin. Since Honest Beauty doesn't have a concealer, I'm gonna use their Everything Cream Foundation in the shade beige. They actually, I think they market this as like a foundation and concealer in one. I've already hit pan on this. I actually really like this formula, and I have a whole video on this if you're curious. But I'm just gonna take my finger, really warm it up, and then just pat it over the areas where I need a little bit more coverage. All right, and then I'm gonna take their Everything Cream Foundation in the shade Almond, and this makes for a great cream bronzer. This is definitely one of my favorite products from Honest Beauty. So I'm just gonna take that around the perimeter of my face with my sponge. All right, and then I'm gonna take their Invisible Blurring Loose Powder on a Real Techniques setting brush. And I'm going to set my face. Like I said, this tinted moisturizer is quite dewy. This powder is very, very mattifying though. So this could be a way that you, for those of you who have oily skin, for you to wear this product, because this is a very, very mattifying powder. So I'm really only setting the T-zone and my under eye area. So I'm gonna go in with a couple more complexion products, and then we'll get on to their blushes. So I'm first gonna go in with their Luminizing Glow Powder in the shade, what is this? Midnight Reflection, oh my goodness. I'm just gonna take a tiny bit of this. I love this formula. I don't love this shade. I really wish they would come out with more shades because this is a little light for me and it comes off a little bit icy. But I'm just gonna take a tiny bit of it. All right, and then I'm gonna take their Luminizing Glow Powder in the shade Dusk Reflection. All right, so I was super excited to hear that they launched their powder blushes because I love their cream blush formula. So I have their Cream Cheek Blush in Coral Peach. Oh my goodness, can't open it though. Okay, here we go. So this is what their cream blushes look like. They are, it's such an amazing formula. I don't know why I don't have more shades because these are truly an incredible formula, especially for those of you who have oily skin or you don't like the feel of cream blushes on your face, you will really like these. They're a nice kind of cream to powder formula. So when they launched these powder blushes, I was super excited to try these. And they did send all of these products to me, and I'll have all that information in the description box below. But these are their Lit Powder Blushes. They retail for $12.99, and you get 0.138 ounces. There are four shades. I have all four shades. The claims on this, it claims to be a blush and a highlighter, just hybrid. So you're getting your blush and your highlighter all in one. And it claims to have a soft focus finish and be long wearing. This is a vegan formula, and it does contain sustainably sourced mica, is talc free, and it does have artificial colors in it. So like I said, I have all three colors. I have Frisky, which I think is the deepest one. Yeah, that's the deepest one. Femme, which looks like that. Foxy, which is a nice peach. This is definitely the one that I think I like the most. And then Flirty, which is kind of your true pink. But I actually really like the shade range. I think they did a really good job, especially with these two deeper shades. These are going to be great for deeper skin tones. I just wish they took that into consideration with their tinted moisturizer. But today, I think I'm going to use Flirty because it's that perfect like spring pink, and yeah, I really like this shade. So I will say these are super shimmery, but they're not glittery. They look really nice on the skin, and they don't have like that chunky glitter. And I'm just gonna work this onto the apples of my cheeks. And actually, I'm gonna take a little bit of Femme, which is one of the deeper kind of berry shades. And I'm just gonna show you how this looks on my skin tone, because this looks a little intimidating, but it's very wearable. You just have to use a tiny bit. They kind of remind me of the Antonym Baked Highlighting Blushes, if you've ever tried those, but with more pigment. Those I find don't have a ton of pigment. These do. It also reminds me of the Burt's Bees blushes, if you've ever tried those. So I actually really like this formula. I love the packaging, and I think these are nice. I think they're definitely worth a try if you like their cream blushes, but you want a powder blush to add to your collection. I think these are really nice. All right, so I scooted you in so we can do the brows, because they do have new brow pencils, which is super exciting. So these are just their brow pencils. They retail for $9.99. You get 0.046 ounces. The only thing is there's only two shades. I have both of them, and I'll show you swatches of them side by side. The claims, you're supposed to have natural looking brows, which I think is kind of a weird claim, because I feel like it just depends on how you apply it and just your technique. It has conditioning jojoba oil, and that's actually the first ingredient in this pencil. It also has squalane, beeswax, and soybean oil. So this is not a vegan formula. I'm going to use taupe towards the front of my brow, and then I'm going to use brown towards the tail end of my brow. All right, so there are my brows. It's a nice pencil. I don't think there's really anything revolutionary about it. It reminds me a lot of my Benecos pencil. If y'all can hear noise, the wind. That's the wind. It's so crazy outside right now, so I'm so sorry about that. But even with it having jojoba oil as the first ingredient, it's not creamy. It's actually a quite stiff, waxy formula. So I think it's nice. I don't like when brow pencils are too creamy. I think they get messy and it's a little harder to fill in the brows, but it's nice. Again, it's not like anything revolutionary. I think it's very similar to my Benecos one, but if you're just in need of a new brow pencil, I think it's nice and I will definitely continue to use it. So to set my brows in place, this is something that I've talked about for a while, but I actually like using their mascara primer as a brow gel. So I'm just gonna run this through my brows and set those in place. I'm just gonna do a really simple eye look. I don't have their eyeshadow palette, so I'm just gonna use my bronzer and just kind of throw this all over my lid. All right, and then I'm going to use that same mascara on my lashes. So I do have a new lip product. This is not new to the line, but it's new to me. This is their tinted lip balm. I got the shade Fruit Punch. Oh my gosh, these are incredible. I'd always heard really, really good things about these, but yeah, it's super, super good. So nice. It reminds me of the L'Oreal Colorish lipsticks. I don't remember what they were called, but they were basically like a glossy tinted lip balm. That's exactly what this reminds me of. Those used to be my favorite. I obviously don't use those anymore, but this is so nice. It's very glossy. It's very balmy, very comfortable. The color's not too overwhelming, and I will definitely be picking up more of these because this is so gorgeous. I also love their liquid lipsticks. These are fantastic. These are excellent, excellent lip products. Highly recommend. All right, guys, so that completes this video. I hope you found it helpful. I think the standout product for me from this range are their blushes. I think these are great. They're super affordable, as with most Honest Beauty products. So I think if you're looking for a new powder blush, you like shimmery blushes, these are a great option. I actually really enjoyed the tinted moisturizer more than I thought. It's just not the most long-wearing product, and they need to expand their shade range so badly. 4 shades, it's not enough at all. So other than that, I quite enjoyed this. So I hope you found this review helpful. If you have any additional questions, please comment below. If there's something that I left out, I try and be as thorough as possible, but you know, without making this video an hour long, I have to condense a lot of it. So definitely let me know if you have any questions down below. Thank you so much for watching. As always, remember, I love you, God loves you, and I'll see y'all in my next video. Bye, guys.